Who would have thought that these little images, available and free online, can allow you to create animations this easily? Easy, quick, and free. Now, let's get into these sprite sheets. We'll be using 100% free tools. Free pick for sprite sheets, and Photopea to use them. All free, no skills required. Our plan for today, take 5 examples, increasing in complexity, each example with a special use case and pro tip, and of course, show you how to do it. We'll go from a basic example of a single cycle animation, another example with a case of multiple cycle animation, another one with a case of movement and layering, another one with a case of important frame correction, and our final example with multiple characters and movements. Let's go. I'll be looking for sprite sheets. Got plenty to choose from. We got this cartoon explosion, this cat running, this bird flying, this bunny running, and this 2D game character with some fighting scenes. Let's start with the first one. You download it in EPS format, and you open it in Photopea. Once you're in there, make sure you have this option activated. It will allow you to see what you're selecting on the right panel. Talking about the right panel, you can see these different groups. Each one is a step of the animation. All you need to do is click on it. Locate which step of the animation it is. In this case, step 1. Right-click and convert to Smart Object. You do this for each of the animation cycle, making sure you name it in the correct order. Once you're done, double-click on it. You can now click File, then Export to PNG. Do the same for each of the animation cycle images. In this case, from 1 to 8. Now that we have our images, let's look for a proper background. A desert scene should do it. Open your video editor and import your assets. Select a short frame duration. I chose 0.1 seconds. And place your frames one by one in order. Test your animation and create a compound clip. You now have the base that you can duplicate, resize, and reposition on your scene. For the little cat, we do the same thing. Download in EPS format and open in Photopea. Same as before, you remove any elements that you don't want, in this case, the shadows, and you locate your objects on the right panel. Rename in the order of the sequence, in this case, from 1 to 6, and create smart objects with each one. And once again, you double-click on them to open them in a separate window, and export them one by one. Now we look for a suiting background for our little cat, and this living room will do just fine. I download it in image format and head on to the video editor, in this case, Capcut. Unlike our previous example, this time, we need the animation to keep on going. So we place our frames one by one, create a compound clip. Now we can duplicate as much as we want to keep the animation going. Put in the background, resize the cat, and apply keyframes to make it move. Place the first keyframe on the left of the living room and the last keyframe on the right, and test out the speed. You might need to speed it up. For that, just slide the keyframe to the left until the speed is good. And you got a running cat in a matter of minutes. Let's get to the bird. I'm not going to go over the same thing again, because it's the exact same thing. But here is our little twist. After we create our individual frames, we can split the background. Head on to search for a jungle background, but this time, download it in Vector EPS format. This will allow us to create foregrounds and backgrounds. So when you open it, try to locate your foreground, in this case, these massive leaves, and hide it using the eye icon. Export the background without it. Then, go back to your foreground, create a smart object, and download it as a separate PNG. Now we have a background and a foreground that we can work with. Place your animation frames, and as you can see, we have this little glitch in the animation. That's because the size of the frames are different from one another. The solution? Locate the frame with the smallest size, and resize the other ones to that size. Bring each frame above our reference frame, and resize using a reference point. In this case, we use the head to get the same bird size. We do this for each frame. adapt the size to the reference frame. And when we're done, we get a smoother animation. Now, insert the background and the foreground with our bird in between them. And similarly to the previous example, we use keyframes to make our little bird fly. Slide it left and right to adjust the speed. And it does appear behind our foreground as we wanted. For the rabbit, same thing. Except we have a larger set that has a lot of positions. This means you can make a lot of moves with just this character set, but we'll only use the running animation, which is composed of these 10 frames. We do the same operation, save each one in a separate PNG file. For the background, you can modify it by removing objects and playing with foregrounds and backgrounds. Sometimes, the file will be too small, and we'll create a pixeled image file. In this case, open up a new artboard with the resolution that you want. Copy-paste it, and resize it as you wish. You should generally go for at least 2,000 pixels. Once we have our background, we import everything in CapCut. We put the frames one by one, in order, and we test. And here, the size difference is even bigger, and creates a bigger glitch. So we just resize following the smallest one, and apply the same thing as the previous example. And you got a running rabbit in the forest. And the final example, the 2D game. This one should be fun. We bring in our sheet and Photopea, and as you can see, we have different poses and actions for this gaming character. We have many to choose from, but we'll just go with this hatch attack movement for now. Locate each group. In this example, the layers already have names of the action. Same as before, create a smart object for each layer and export each one in a separate file, as we did previously. And the special twist here is that we can actually bring in another character. Yes, this sprite sheet comes in many variations. We can also bring in this character, or this one, or this one. I think I'll just go with this one. I also go to get my background. And there is a special trick. As you can see, I have thousands of groups here on the right panel. And it's hard to select these little guys that I want to delete. So just click on any part of their body and scroll up to the parent folder or group and apply the eye icon and export as usual. Now that you have your frames and your background, import everything into CapCut and do the same steps of resizing your frames to fit the smallest one. A special twist here is that you might need to add some longer frames of your character standing still. At the beginning, and the end of your animation. So you can go back to your sprite sheets and look for idle positions to add. Bring it in and space it. Just enough for the character to be in a natural position, before and after the action. You might also need to resize, as it's necessary in most cases to avoid those glitchy movements. Then place and size both of your characters, and adjust the timing of the actions by sliding your frames to the proper positions. After adding those keyframes for the movement, there is another thing you can do. Open the keyframe animation panel with the right click, and adjust the curve of the movement to correspond to your action. In this case, we want a slow start and a swift finish. Just drag this handle until you get the right curve. Test and adjust, and you got yourself a nice little game animation in a couple of minutes. Ha! Obviously that was not the same animation as in the intro. That one took me a bit longer. Maybe an hour for those seconds of animation. I'll just time-lapse that hour over here. And give you some random advice I think are important. If you want to flip a character, you can simply use the mirror option. You can even use it to make the character turn during motion. If you want to reset an action, you can reverse the compound clip, and it will create the opposite movement. Compound clips are your best friend. Do it as soon as possible. This way you can adjust the speed easier. But if you plan on zooming in, do it before you create the compound clip. Otherwise, you will lose quality. Bring in very high resolution backgrounds. It's way better for zooming without losing quality. Add in other sprite sheets for effects and various accents. you'll find plenty online. And use keyframes on the background for camera movements. I encourage you to start exploring these sprite sheets. And the cool thing is that some creators put out complete sets. I found sets for gaming animations, plenty of them with many variations. You also have cute animals or kids' cartoon characters, as well as more elaborate character sets. So, let me know how you get the best of it down in the comments section. Cheers!